In the earlier class, we have seen about motor rule or Fleming's left hand rule. Now we'll see example 13.2. In example 13.2, they have said on page number 231, example 13.2, an electron beam enters a magnetic field at right angles to it, as shown in figure 13.14. The direction of force acting on the electron will be options to the right, to the left, out of the page and into the page. See here, the magnetic field is directed rightwards. Electron beam is at right angles and coming in the downward direction. And you know the direction of current will be opposite to the direction of electrons. Okay, the direction of current will be opposite to the direction of electrons. So let us apply Fleming's left hand rule and find out the direction of force acting on the electron. So if you apply Fleming's left hand rule like this, the current is moving in the upward direction, the magnetic field is in the rightward direction, then the thumb points in the downward direction. So the force acting on the electron will be into the page. This is the answer for that. Now we'll see in-text questions on page number 231. Which of the following property of a proton can change while it moves freely in a magnetic field? Option A is mass, B is speed, C is velocity, and D is momentum. So for the first in-text question on page number 231, the answer is, speed will change, and velocity will change, and momentum will change. All these three will change. Speed, velocity, and momentum, all these three will change, whereas mass will not change. And let us come to page number 232. Second in-text question. I will just read the question. You can also look into your books and then, listen to me. In activity 13.7, how do we think the displacement of rod AB will be affected? If current in the rod AB is increased, a stronger horseshoe magnet is used, and third, the length of the rod AB is increased. If all these three are increased, then the force acting on the conductor AB will increase. In all these three cases, the force acting on the conductor AB will increase. Then the third in-text question. A positively charged particle, that is alpha particle, projected towards west is deflected towards north by a magnetic field. The direction of magnetic field is, option A is towards south, option B is towards east, option C is downwards, option D is downwards. Now what you can do is, you can apply Fleming's left hand rule or motor rule yourself and find out the direction of magnetic field. Now if you apply Fleming's left hand rule to this, what you come to know is the magnetic field is directed downwards. You can apply left hand rule to it and see it for yourself. Now let us see the Let us see the definition of electric motor. Now, electric motor is a rotating device, okay, which converts electrical energy into mechanical energy. So, what is an electric motor? An electric motor is a rotating device which converts electrical energy into mechanical energy. So, motor converts electrical energy into mechanical energy. Now, let us see the construction of a motor. Now, you can see the diagram given in figure 13.15, which is a simple electric motor, on page number 232. You can draw this diagram also. Now, here ABCD is a rectangular coil of insulated copper wire. ABCD is a rectangular coil of insulated copper wire which is mounted between the poles of a strong permanent magnet. Okay, ABCD is a rectangular coil of insulated copper wire mounted between the poles of a powerful magnet. Now here, the end A and end D are soldered to carbon brushes X and Y. End A is soldered to carbon brush X, D is soldered to carbon brush Y. And X and Y are connected to split rings. Okay, P and Q. P and Q are copper split rings. Okay, P and Q are copper split rings. These copper split rings are insulated from inside and they are slipped over an axle. Okay, they are slipped over an axle, and X and Y, the brushes, are connected to a battery through a plug K. Now, this is the construction of a DC motor. See, once again, ABCD is a rectangular coil of insulated copper wire which is mounted between the north and south poles of a permanent magnet. End A is soldered to X, end A is soldered to Y, which X and Y are carbon brushes. X and Y are again in contact with split rings P and Q. Okay, split rings P and Q are insulated from inside and slipped over an axle. And then X and Y are connected to a battery through a plug K. Now, this is the construction of DC motor. Okay, take down these notes. Draw the diagram of DC motor which is given on page number 232. Okay, we'll meet in the next class.